So here we are now. This is day 34 of the shutdown, day 35, less than 2 hours away. That's the day that's important, that 800,000 workers will miss another paycheck. But Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross, here we go, would have you believe that that's not such a big deal?
You're talking about 800,000 workers, and while I feel sorry for the individuals that have hardship cases, 800,000 workers, if they never got their pay, which is not the case, they will eventually get it. But if they never got it, you're talking about 1/3% on our GDP. So it's not like it's a gigantic number overall.
I don't even know what to say after that. Did you hear? Can we play that again, please? Can we just play that again? Okay, play it.
You're talking about 800,000 workers, and while I feel sorry for the individuals that have hardship cases, 800,000 workers, if they never got their pay, which is not the case, they will eventually get it. But if they never got it, you're talking about 1/3% on our GDP. So it's not like it's a gigantic number overall.
By the way, some contractors won't get paid, just so you know. Can you believe that? That is the president's, President Trump, that's his Commerce Secretary, who according to his financial disclosure forms is worth some $700 million. Says he feels sorry for those 800,000 people who haven't been paid, but it's not a gigantic number overall. Just a drop in the bucket. 800,000 people with families to feed and bills to pay. 800,000 people who thought they had good, reliable paychecks from their government jobs. Maybe you are one of them. How do you feel about him saying, it's not a gigantic number? But it gets worse.
There are reports that there are some federal workers who are going to homeless shelters to get food.
Well, I know they are, and I don't really quite understand why, because as I mentioned before, the obligations that they would undertake, say a borrowing from a bank or a credit union, are in effect federally guaranteed. So the 30 days of pay that some people will be out, there's no real reason why they shouldn't be able to get a loan against it.
That is the most elite, out-of-touch thing that I have ever heard in my life, in all my years, ever on this earth. That is the most insulting thing that I've ever heard, the most elite, elitist, however you want to put it, thing that I've ever heard. I could not believe it. I had to go back and I said, I've got to find this on the internet. Is this true? Hey, you folks who aren't getting paid, just go take out a loan. Take out a loan. Here's what he's saying, okay? Follow along with me. Take out a loan for the money that you've earned, the money that we owe you, because we really have no idea when you're going to get paid, even though a lot of you are still on the job. So yeah, take out a loan. Pay interest just to get the money that we owe you. And the Commerce Secretary may know where you can get a loan because his department's Federal Credit Union is offering emergency loans at almost 9% interest. 9%. It's according to the Washington Post. Secretary Ross later tried to clean up his tone-deaf comments. Here it is.
We're aware, painfully aware, that there are hardships inflicted on the individual workers. All I was trying to do is make sure that they're aware that there are possible other things that could help somewhat mitigate their problems.
I'm not sure he's as painfully aware of the hardships as those hundreds of thousands of unpaid workers are. And just listen to this word salad from the President of the United States.
Perhaps you should have said it differently. Local people know who they are when they go for groceries and everything else. And I think what Wilbur is probably trying to say is that they will work along. I know banks are working along. If you have mortgages, the mortgagees, the folks collecting the interest and all of those things, they work along. And that's what happens in time like this. They know the people, they've been dealing with them for years, and they work along. The grocery store, and I think that's probably what Wilbur Ross meant.
Right. Right on. Just go for the groceries and then tell them that they need to work along. Whatever that means. Same for the folks who are collecting interest and all those things. Just tell them, work along. Don't worry, the president appreciates the great job that you're doing. Especially those of you who, he insists, are totally in favor of shutting down the government to get his wall.
I love them, I respect them, I really appreciate the great job they're doing. Many of those people that are not getting paid are totally in favor of what we're doing, because they know the future of this country is dependent on having a strong border, especially a strong southern border.
So people who are sitting there tonight, you guys who are sitting in the comfort of your homes and you're working and getting paid, I'm getting paid, just think about it. Would you be okay with not getting your paycheck? Would you? Honestly, probably not. But what do you expect when you've got a cabinet full of billionaires, all the best people?
We're going to make America great again. We're going to use our best people.
I'm going to get the best people.
We're going to deliver. We're going to get the best people in the world.
All the best people. The president's surrounded by them. And let's not forget all this.
A huge share of government workers were going to take vacation days, say between Christmas and New Year's. And then we have a shutdown, and so they can't go to work, and so then they have the vacation, but they don't have to use their vacation days. And then they come back, and then they get their back pay, then they're, in some sense, they're better off.
Listen, this is, it's not fair to you, and we all get that, but this is so much bigger than any one person. It is a little bit of pain, but it's going to be for the future of our country.
And let's not forget that this was all done on purpose and trumpeted, no pun intended, well, maybe pun intended, trumpeted in advance.
I am proud to shut down the government for border security, Chuck. I will take the mantle. I will be the one to shut it down. I'm not going to blame you for it.
With all the shocking things happening during this shutdown, things we never thought we'd see in this country, this is disgraceful. The Coast Guard says it will not be able to provide death benefits to the families of any members who lose their lives defending this country. Military retirees and their families won't get their checks either.